A very good evening, one and all. We shall start the Engineers' Day celebrations. A very good evening to all the dignitaries present, honorable guests, distinguished faculty members, and my dear friends. A happy Engineers' Day. A nation is not born, it's built. It's built with the calloused hands of visionaries who don't just see the future but give shape to it, who see an opportunity where others see a problem. Visionaries who toil tirelessly under the blazing sun and in the pouring rain, win the toughest terrains and in the harshest conditions, fulfilled just by their belief. Yet they do not believe in the work, in talking. They always prefer in their work. They cut corners, take no shortcuts, and make no compromises. Perfection is the only thing that they settle for. They are the modern builders of India, the shapers of our destinies, the true visionaries who call themselves engineers. On behalf of the Association of Civil Engineers, I wish you all a happy Engineers' Day. This is Sai Teja Barala, a final year BTech civil engineering student, and I am going to be your host for the celebrations tonight. I extend my warm welcome to all those who are presented here for the Engineers' Day celebrations 2020. Before we commence, let me acknowledge and invite the presence of some of our eminent guests. Professor P. Srinivas Rao Garu, President Gayatri Vidya Parishad and Senior Professor in the Department of Civil Engineering. Dr. A.B. Koteshwara Garu, Principal Gayatri Vidya Parishad, College of Engineering, Autonomous. Dr. G. Paparav Garu, Head Department of Civil Engineering. Dr. Professor P. Veerabhadrao Garu, Dean of Infrastructure, Planning and Development. Dr. Manchikanti Srinivas Garu, Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Faculty Coordinator for Association of Civil Engineers. And our proud alumni, Sri TVM Pavan Kumar Sir, General Manager, CBRE South Asia Private Limited. And our proud alumni, Sri V. Sandeep Chaudhary Sir, former Assistant Construction Manager, L&T Construction. And all the distinguished faculty members, staff, and my dear student friends, I once again welcome you for the Engineers' Day celebrations 2020. Now, I call upon Ms. Jansi from third year to brief us about the significance of Engineers' Day.
A warm welcome and good evening, respected Principal Sir, Dean Sir, HOD Sir, faculty, staff, and my dear friends. Today, we all gathered to celebrate 53rd Engineers' Day. My tribute to the significant engineering mind of the nation, Bharat Ratna Sri Mokshagundam Vishveshwaraya Garu, on his birthday. Every year, the engineering fraternity celebrates Engineers' Day on 15th September to commemorate the great contribution of Bharat Ratna Mokshagundam Vishveshwaraya Garu. As he made many exceptional contributions to the country, he was honored with the highest state award of the India, the Bharat Ratna, in the year 1955. He received international recognition for his genius in harnessing water resources, successful design and construction of several dams, bridges, and implementing irrigation and drinking water schemes all over India. Engineers operate at the interface of science and society. Engineers are the backbone of development and technology. Today, India has progressed in the area of space research, defense development, rural development, renewable energies, agriculture and food processing, information and communication technology, education, etc., due to the enormous contribution of engineers from various disciplines. I would like to end with a very famous quote uttered by M. Vishveshwaraya Garu. The way to build a nation is to build a good citizen. The majority of the citizens should be efficient, of good character, and possess a reasonable high sense of duty. Thank you.
Thank you, Jansi, for your short and informative speech. Now, I would request our Honorable Principal Dr. A.B. Koteshwarrao sir to address the gathering and give his valuable inputs to the students.
It is a hello. Our principal sir, because of our 8th semester exams are going on in the campus, both in afternoon and morning and afternoon session. He is busy with the proceedings of conduct of exams. However, he conveyed his best wishes to all our students, faculty members, and our alumni members. I think we can proceed for the next point of the agenda.
Yes, sir. Now, we would like to present a short video on the Indian engineers. I would request our head of the Department of Civil Engineering, Dr. G. Paparao sir, to share a few words with the students.
Respected Professor P. S. Raugar in absence, he will be joining in the middle of the meeting. He is attending urgent meeting. President Gayatri Vidya Parishad and Senior Professor of Civil Engineering, Professor P. S. Raugar. And Professor A.B.K. Rao garu, principal, he could not join because of 8th semester exams going on in the campus. He is busy with the conduct of proceedings. Our faculty members, distinguished faculty members, today's guest of honors, Sri T.V.M. Pavan Kumar, General Manager Projects, CBR South Asia Private Limited, and Sri V. Sanjeev Chaudhary, former Assistant Construction Manager, L&T Constructions, all my faculty members and staff of civil department and my dear student friends, and also our heads of various departments. Some of our heads also joined in this occasion. A very good evening and happy Engineers Day greetings to one and all. First of all, I welcome you all for today's Engineers Day celebrations organized by Department of Civil Engineering under the aegis of Association of Civil Engineers. First of all, my sincere thanks to our today's guests and our distinguished alumni members for immediately accepting our invitation and addressing the today's budding engineers. I also thank all our my faculty and students for and also heads of various departments for joining this program within a short notice. I also thank all the organizing members of different student chapters of Department of Civil Engineering under the AS and for being conducted various technical events among the students of our own institutions of Gayatri Vidya Parishat and also among the students of other institutions, both statewide and nationwide. Even in this pandemic situation, they have been conducting since March 2020 till yesterday, till this occasion of Engineers Day. Continuously they are organizing different events among the students. And really, just before closing, I would like to tell a small message about the importance of various student chapters. These student chapters get a true value from the extracurricular activities, the chapter hosts, and also the students will get extra contacts with the outside world and chance to meet other students with the different viewpoints. I request all the organizing committee of the various student chapters of our Department of Civil Engineering to host weekly events, inviting the speakers from the industry and also from the academia, from reputed national institutes, and also arranging the technical talks by inviting our distinguished alumni members working in different industries, like our today's guests Pawan Kumar and Sandeep Chaudhary. All of you are aware, all the students, you have received one mail from our principal, sir. One of our alumni who is graduated in 2012, belongs to 2009-12 batch, Dr. D. Pradeep Kumar, who did his B.Tech civil engineering from our department and passed out in 2012. And he secured All India rank in a GATE exam, and he got admission in IIT Guwahati for his M.Tech program. And also he finished his PhD program also from IIT Guwahati. And during his I request all the participants to mute their audio. He finished his both M.Tech and PhD programs from IIT Guwahati. And during his stay at IIT Guwahati, around 12, he secured 12 achievements by Minister of Human Resource Development and also from Department of Science and Technology. And finally, got selected as a faculty in the Department of Civil Engineering at IIT Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Selecting faculty in IITs is not an easy job unless we have so many credentials. Even we are not eligible to apply for that positions. This is one of the example I given. Like Dr. Pradeep Kumar, we have several or many distinguished alumni members working in various industries, very distinguished in industries, and also working in different institutions in both in India and abroad. I request all the students to take very serious in both your curricular activities and the extracurricular activities during your stay in the Department of Civil Engineering. in these 4 years, particularly the second and third years. And this is the small message I would like to share among our students as well as our faculty members. And coming to our today's celebration, today we are celebrating Engineers Day on the eve of birthday of Sri M. Visvesvaraya, Sir Mokshgunda Visvesvaraya, known as Sir MV, at a flair for complex engineering problems in the national building. It is to honor his Engineers Day on his birthday, that is 15th September. Sir M. Visvesvaraya was an eminent civil engineer born in Karnataka and graduated in civil engineering from Pune University, Maharashtra. He was a great scholar and one of the greatest engineers India has ever seen. Would like to remember about few things about our Sir MV. After topping the Pune College of Engineering, he was directly, without interview, recruited by the government of Bombay, then and appointed as assistant engineers in the Public Works Department. He created automatic sluice gates, which was later reused for Tigra Dam, Madhya Pradesh, and KRS Dam, that is close to our Vrindavan Gardens, one of the then biggest dam in the India. And for his design, he was supposed to get a recurring income in the form of royalty from the government, but he refused to take it so that the government could use this money for more developmental project. Later, he patented and installed an irrigation system with water flood gates at the reservoir near Pune to raise the flood supply level and storage to the highest levels. Between 1895 and 1905, he worked in different parts of India. In Hyderabad, he improved the drainage system. In Bombay, he introduced the block system of irrigation and waterway flood gates. In Bihar and Orissa, he was a part of the building railway projects and water supply schemes also. In Mysore, he supervised the construction of KRS Dam, but then Asia's biggest dam. He was offered a diwanship, like Prime Minister position of Mysore in 1908, and given full responsibility of all the developmental projects. Under his diwanship, Mysore saw major transformation in the dreams of agriculture, irrigation, industrialization, education, and banking sector, and commerce. He was conferred with India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna, in 1955 for his contribution towards engineering. He was not only praised by the Indian government, but also received honorary awards and memberships from all over the world. Sir Visvesvaraya was not only known for his contributions in the field of engineering, but also called the precursor of economic planning in India. So this is a small message I would like to share among all the participants. Once again, happy engineers to greetings to all the participants. And finally, I request all the members of student chapters of different committees to expand their activities into new directions and adding new benefits for those who join the various student chapters. This is the small message I would like to share. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I thank Dr. Manchakan Srinivasgaru for his valuable guidance for these student chapters, for sparing his valuable time. Thank you, one and all, and thanks for giving me this opportunity. Thank you. I welcome Professor Veerbhadra Aru, Dean Infrastructure, for this event.
Thank you so much.
Valuable information and message. Now I would request Professor P. Veerbhadra Rao sir to speak a few words with the students. Sir, we invite you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity. But in fact, my audio will be cut perhaps. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm traveling actually. Maybe the audio may not be in correct position. But however, this is your time. It's nice that you are conducting these type of programs on this Engineers Day. I wish that it should go very smoothly. I also welcome our former students, both Pawan as well as Sandeep, who are to be favorable students of the department. I look forward for your speech. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, we would present a video on the miracles of civil engineering.
I got supplies.
Towers to the largest tunnels, some of the world's largest civil engineering wonders are just being built. The capabilities of civil engineers and architects are only growing as engineering software and scientific research advance their fields. While you may look back on projects and think that the Hoover Dam or the Burj Khalifa is the best civil engineering we'll ever get, let's take a look at a few projects that might be even more impressive. Las Vegas Convention Center Tunnel, above and underneath the well-trodden streets of Sin City, is the development of a $52.5 million tram network for the Las Vegas Convention Center. While work initially began above ground on this high-profile transportation system, the below-ground tunneling work marks the first commercial project for Elon Musk's Boring Company. The tunnel will span 1.5 miles under Las Vegas and will be capable of moving 4,400 passengers per hour, turning a 15-minute walk into a 2-minute ride. While this may not seem all that impressive, it's a major milestone in underground engineering. Tunnel digging may be centuries old, but commercializing the process for transport on a large scale could well expand the use of transportation tunnels to many other metropolises. Musk and the Boring Company have already broken through one part of the tunnel, and they expect to have the project open to the public in January 2021, just in time for the CES, if it happens. Jeddah Tower, Saudi Arabia. While you've probably heard of the Burj Khalifa, you might not have heard the name Jeddah Tower yet. Construction on the tower began in 2013, and when it's completed in 2021, it's set to take the new crown as the world's tallest skyscraper. However, the construction process has been plagued with labor and staffing issues, causing it to make very slow progress. Also known as the Kingdom Tower, the building will reach a minimum of 0.62 miles into the air and will be the centerpiece of the Jeddah Economic City, which is a $20 billion project stretched over 2 square miles. Hong Kong Zhuhao Macai Bridge. Now that we've examined two impressive projects that are planned to be completed soon, let's take a look at a civil engineering wonder that was recently finished. Construction on the Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge began all the way back in 2009 and was completed in February of 2018. This civil engineering mega project isn't just your normal bridge though. It's the longest sea crossing and the longest open sea fixed link in the entire world. Designed to last 120 years, the bridge spans the Lingding and Zhuzhou channels, connecting Hong Kong, Macau, and Zhuhai, three major cities on the Pearl River Delta. The project involved constructing a series of interconnected bridges, artificial islands, and tunnels, and cost around $18.8 billion. It stretches a blistering 34 miles across the open ocean. The main section includes a 14.2 mile viaduct and a 4.2 mile undersea tunnel that runs between two artificial islands. High-speed railway, California. While the United States has long had a network of railroads running from east to west, what it doesn't have is particularly fast trains. While there are some high-speed rail networks operated at speeds of around 100 miles per hour, that's no match for the bullet trains of Japan, which regularly run at 200 miles per hour. However, all of that is starting to change. California is working on constructing a high-speed train network that could completely change the transportation landscape of the state. Construction on the project began back in 2015, but it won't be completed until 2029, assuming there aren't any delays. It will cover a distance of 280 miles and provide a connection between the state's two population centers in just 2 hours and 40 minutes. Work is continuing on a 171-mile core segment of the track, but due to massive budget overruns, the rest of the track's completion has been thrown into limbo. If completed, this will be a big leap forward for U.S. transportation infrastructure projects. The future of civil engineering projects is looking bright. We're building taller towers, bigger, more usable tunnels, longer bridges, and more impressive structures. It seems that nothing can overcome the desire to build things bigger and better than what's been done before.
Now, I would request Mr. T. Uday Kumar, a final year BTech student, to brief up about the events conducted by the Association of Civil Engineers during this pandemic lockdown period and also on the eve of Engineers Day.
Good evening, everybody. The department has three different student clubs affiliated to following professional societies, namely the Institutions of Engineers, the Institute of Civil Engineers, Indian Green Building Council. Under the aegis of Association of Civil Engineers, Institution Engineers Students of Departments of the Students of Department publish a monthly e-magazine titled Nirman. During this pandemic lockdown period also, Students Chapters has organized various technical events. Let us go through them. The Institution of Civil Engineers Student Chapter has spread its wings on the organized events not only at a college level, but also at national level to help out students all over the country. As the part of it, they conducted their first national level visual online quiz competition named Grill Your Cash on 3rd October. We got a huge number of registrations from 23 states of India to foreign countries. We received a total 731 registrations and received a good feedback from participants. Nirman team publishes e-magazine regarding the civil engineering, latest technology, ancient and new constructions, and fun games like crosswords, jumbles, etc. related to civil engineering. On an average, gets nearly 400 views. The Institute of Civil Engineers, United Kingdom's student chapter, has conducted creative events like online quiz on 10th April and presentations on 1st July based on the failures of structure, and a model making competition on 20th July for budding civil engineers. The club has not even let a single month go waste. They have launched a website for case showing all their activities for publishing an e-leaflet on 15th August for benefits of our fellow students. The Institute of Civil Engineers student chapter has conducted a Indian Green Building Council's vision to enable a sustainable built environment for all and facilitate India to one of the global leaders in the sustainable built environment by 2025. IGBC student chapter is constantly striving to fulfill the vision of IGBC Professional Society. The team is going to launch a leaflet today in this grand occasion in few minutes. Thank you.
Thank you, Uday. Now I would call upon Ms. Nikhila from third year to introduce one of our guest of honors, Sri TVM Pawan Kumar sir.
Good evening, everyone. I consider it a privilege to introduce Mr. TVM Pawan Kumar. Mr. Kumar has more than 15 years of experience in construction industry and worked with various companies in India. He is a chartered civil engineer and member of Institution of Civil Engineers, UK, and accredited professional of Indian Green Building Council. He worked in various capacities in the corporate and has experience in project planning, execution, and delivery of multi-billion dollar projects. Pawan Tamari Garu has pursued his BTech in civil engineering from Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering in 1999 to 2003 batch, which was the first civil engineering batch of our college, and his master's in advanced construction management from NICMAR. Mr. Kumar writes blogs on project management and real estate. He answers queries on technical in various educational and social network websites. I now invite TVM Pawan Kumar sir to enlighten the audience with his words.
Sir, please switch on your mic, sir.
So, thank you for the introduction. I hope you can hear me now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so that's great. Thank you. So, good evening, all. Good evening, Principal Professor P.S. Rao Garu, Dean Virupadrao sir, Papa Rao sir, and Manchkan Srinivas Rao Garu, and Professor, supporting staff, my civil engineers, and the students. I wish you all a happy Engineers Day. Being the Engineers Day. Before getting into this, I thank the HOD and the Association of the Civil Engineers for inviting me to these celebrations. In fact, I come here out of my will here because the Teja has called me and immediately said because I have to give back to my college. So that is the reason I immediately okayed it and I came here for this evening. There is an attachment to this great institute, and there is an attachment to my teachers. On behalf of all present here, I wish to thank my teachers for the professional position which I am enjoying today is because of them. At the same moment, I seek their blessings. I owe a lot to this institute, the STVM Institute, Gayatri Viksha Parishad College of Engineering. This great institute has given me not only the degree, the bachelor's degree, but has given me the discipline. It has given me the life, the teachers, basically the teachers here shaped my character. The teachers helped me to face the world with the bravery and the courage. In fact, they gave me the strength to survey in this world. So wherever I go, I proudly say I am from the Gayatri College. I'm the alumni of the civil batch of 1999. Kindly allow me to express my gratitude towards my teachers present here in this evening. I would like to share my few of my life experiences before getting into the deeper into the my thing to speak. This I would like to recollect an incident because being a project manager, because we when I go to site, something some changes will occur because of the site conditions. The design per se will change the designs according to that suits the site situation. Because that we take the decisions on spot sometimes, and we consult the designers online. And then the design we generally what I do, I'll put up a sketch and I'll pass on to the my draftsman, my design manager, to put it in a drawing so that the same can be communicated to all the consultant as well, all the stakeholders. Because whatever the small change we do in the project, it has to be shared with all the team members, all the stakeholders. So when I do the sketches, so immediately I'll pass on to the design managers, and they start putting up in the AutoCAD, and there are many other softwares like Revit, and they put it in the AutoCAD and they make a draft, they have the plot, and then they plot it. So many times this things, because I regularly what happens, I push up because you see, even project is an urgency because we need to deliver on time the project. So I push my team members to deliver on time. So out of urgency, I'll stand beside them, beside their PCs, and I'll because the draftsmen have he will start using the AutoCAD and he'll take some time. But I stand beside them and put up their PC and dictate the commands promptly. And they ask me, sir, how can you tell the command so easily? Because you don't work on a regular basis, because you don't draft the advance. So at that time I say, because it was what my teachers has taught me. Whenever this incident happens, I simply smile because this is all what my teacher has told. And the teacher is my sir, Manchganti sir. Thank you, Manchganti sir. I still remember the CAD classes, the classes which still it is wavering in my brain. Similarly, the soil mechanic classes, highway engineering, whatever the classes you have taken, still that captures in mind. So that is how sir, you have tried to embed the concept into the brains. So I still remember the way you teach. I still feel I was in the class. So automatically the whatever you teach, that comes out of my mouth so easily. This is because of my greatness of being here in the Gayatri College of Engineering, because I got such great teachers. I will also share one more incident it's an important incident that was occurred during my time with the Ringiriswath with L&T last time to grow. I was at the senior engineer level. I'm overseeing the construction, because basically I was joined in L&T as a site in GET, that is called a graduate engineer training. I was at the execution, and then I moved to planning, then I was in execution. So most of my time was in planning and execution on site only. So because I'm overseeing one of the phases in an IT park in Chennai. At the time I was in Chennai then. So we are doing a topographical survey of the plot. So my project manager at the time asked me to go to the site and do a survey of the project site. And he has given me a crew of team of one surveyor, and then some junior engineers are there, GETs are there. So my task is to do the topographical survey of the plot. So but the surveyor is a senior guy, because he is experienced more than me, and he got around 10 to 15 years more, and he's also admin person because of his age and other things. He is very much admin. So it was the incident that happened. He has completed the survey. Then as usually, he has done the set up the benchmark and everything. So initially I asked him to asked him to explain the process on the survey which he had adapted. And then he started bashing me because he is a senior and he think that I know what to do. You should not tell anything. Then I changed my tone, because it is my responsibility to tell to my project manager, this is the task which I completed, and this is what the topography levels in on this. So then I changed my tone and I started questioning him, the surveyor. So have you checked the block levels? And he said yes. Have you taken the block level spot level? Yes, he said yes. And asked about the contour mapping. He told that he has taken the contour mapping, and then also cross checked the map and also witnessed the thing. And then I asked him, have you set up the benchmarks? He said that he has shown me the benchmarks on site. He had very diversity. How a small guy, person who doesn't have any experience on, means inquiring all these things. And then I asked him, go on questioning on benchmarks and then how he transferred. And then finally I asked him one question, have you done a traverse closing? So he puzzled, no, he has not done. Finally he has not done. So then he started asking me, how you know that you can close here, the traverse has to be closed, and how you know the principle, because you are engineer, you only do the concreting job and you do the check the form, but how you got the experience. Then this is what I told, because I learned it from the college. I remember my teacher, Virabhadra sir, who has taught me the surveying. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I got this opportunity to thank you again for teaching the basics. And I still remember he used to take us to the different sites and to understand the practical knowledges. The way he imparted the practical knowledge, the how to understand the things, because civil engineering basically mostly of practical knowledge. So what you look at that site, what you see at site, that is how you can learn. So basically, that's done in books and theories. The civil engineering consists of the more of the practical knowledge. So that is how I remember my teachers. Every day, means any time when I gather, because I'm at this position because of all my teachers who have taught me here. There are many such incidents in my professional life where I recollect the wisdom of the great teachers of this institute. I want to share all such incidents, but because of the time limitation here, I restrict myself here and I cannot tell more on this. Because Tejas told me that there is a limitation of time, because obviously everything should have been delivered in the time period. And also, my profound gratitude to Professor P.S. Rao Garu. We are very, the 1999 batch was very much lucky to have him as a teacher. Sir has told us on structural engineering, the concepts. Still, I remember the classes, how he taught us. Also, thank Paparo sir, Kishore sir, V.V. Ravi sir, who has taught us geotechnical engineering, along with the teachers of mechanical and electrical departments, who taught us on electrical engineering and mechanical engineering. But last but not the least, I also thank Hira Singh, Hanumant, Krishnanna for their support and encouragement in the laboratories. They're very helpful for us during the lab periods and during the vivas. My thanks to Shyam as well as, and also I remember Bhavani madam, who are there at our time. We are here today to celebrate the Engineers Day as a remembrance of Sri Mosagunda Visvesvarayya. We all know that we are celebrating this day because on his birthday. There are many engineers in India, but why we celebrate his birthday as Engineers Day? Do you have anyone have the idea, students? We know he did many things like block irrigation system. He has designed automatic valve, which was patented. He has done the KK Krishna Raj Sagar project. He designed the drainage system of the entire Hyderabad. He tamed the Musi River, Usman Sagar. He was also a statesman. He made industrialization. Because he is the person who has started up the many factories like the Mysore soap factory, the Mysore soap factory, sandal factory, and then iron and steel, Mysore lamps. Similarly, he has done many things. Even there is a company of paint company he has industrialized. He has set up a crucial role in setting up the Mysore University. He was into the financial and commerce. He has set up Bank of Mysore. So he has done many of things. He has done even he was the backbone of setting up the HAL Aviation Aeronautical Limited. So his achievements can run into the pages, and hundreds of pages. So because of this question has been lingering me, why should the world is celebrating him, his birthday as Engineer's Day. So then I started to understand him. So I read his autobiographies. Similarly, and the books which were written on him. There are almost 5 to 6 books are there, which was written by other different authors. And there is one biography which was written, and there is one book which was written by Vishwesiraya. So I thought of reading in my time. I've just gone through all these books. So let us understand what made him a great engineer. So what would be the main thing is he has the few things which differentiate him with the rest of the others. One, the first is the is eagerness to learn. The first one is eagerness to learn. The other thing, this is what I what by my understanding when I read his books. The other thing is discipline, and the honesty and the work ethics. So nowadays people losing on the honesty and the ethical part. So at the time he was very honest and the ethical things. And the other thing is the passion of civil engineering. And the other fifth one is the dedication and excellency. These are the 5 things which made him stand apart from other engineers in the world. So when you see, you could have gone, most of you read in the internet and WhatsApp. See, if you see in the discipline part, you would have, a folklore is something like this, because people in the Mysore, and in the Mysore, use it to stay in Mysore. So people use it to set their time on their watches based on his movements, because he was so punctual that he used to go to office at around 8 o'clock. So people used to see Moshikun Vishwesiraya sir on the streets, and they used to check the time. Okay, so if this person is going, then the time must be 8 o'clock. So that is how the discipline system he has. Eagerness to learn. This is one of the incidents which I read in the book. So one at the age of I think around 85 plus, he has gone to one of the US for a steel, as a visit for a steel factory. So his friend told me this is the new machinery that makes the production very faster, and he also told, and that is around something around I think around 100 feet high silos or something. So that gentleman has told to MV sir, this is automatic system, and to know how the gear system and how the mechanism. So one has to get into the top of the silo, and then only you can understand the thing. So he has got some youngsters also to study the procedure, but no one has tried to. Even youngster didn't try to. But this sir, MV Moshikunda Vishwesiraya sir, he has immediately removed his coat, and then he removed his shoes, and then climbed the ladder, and then going into the factory production, and he has seen the thing. So that is what you understand is his eagerness to learn. Whatever the new thing is coming up, there should be eagerness to learn. Whatever the subjects you feel that whatever the areas you want to go, you want to grow up, you want to learn. So you should have the eagerness. The other thing is the honesty and the work ethics. So he was very much ethical person. He never used the government because the government as his profession, the government has given him a lot of things like car, traveling for purpose. They given them car, some other thing. But he never used those things. He has been very honest and used ethical to his job. So whenever he has to travel somewhere, he used to travel on his own car. So there are many such examples. So once you read this book, you get inspired. The other thing is what I felt is most interesting part is the passion towards his engineering and civil engineering. So what happened? This person has done his graduation from Pune. So after Pune, he was posted in Nasik. So from Nasik, he has moved to Madras, at that time Chennai, Madras, and then he's going to Hyderabad, he has moved to Delhi. So as is because most of the youngsters feel that civil engineering, they always compare it with the jobs of other industry like pharmaceutical, software. We doesn't have any station jobs because civil, being a civil engineer, when you work on projects, definitely you have to move on to different places. And even Moshgundu Vishresh has moved all over the pan India. He worked projects in different states. He worked in Kashmir, he worked in Northeast, he had taken up some projects in Northeast, he worked in down south. So he has been moving. So this is the most, because he is moving because he has the passion to work. He has a passion of civil engineering. There are no boundaries to work. So here my advice to all the civil engineers, the budding civil engineers is don't restrict yourself to work at your hometown, cities. Generally people say, no, if I have a job in Hyderabad, then I'll work there. If I have a job somewhere in Vizag, I'll settle there and work. No such thing. And then people again comment in the reverse way that there are no opportunities for civil engineers. No such thing. So there are empty opportunities that are there, but you have to be free yourself. You have to come out of your framework. You have to come out of your the place. So you don't get a job because you don't get a job in Vizag. You don't get in Hyderabad. So you have to move around wherever you get the job. So keep moving. So that is what he has told to all the youngsters. So because civil engineers are like nomadic, means like people move one place to another. We are like that only. So people who are in the projects, mostly civil engineers who are in the projects, they do this because we create a place, because we go to a place where there is nothing is there and we make the things happen there. So when suppose come back to the our state itself, AP. See, erstwhile government has developed Amaravati. So because before Amaravati there is nothing, that is only farmlands are there. But civil engineers have been there. The engineers have been there. They created the spaces. They created the lifeline. And then they made the history. So that is how the Amaravati is being built. Not only Amaravati, there are, you can new Raipur, that is the Chhattisgarh capital. So all these things, the new cities are being built by civil engineers. We go to the places where there is no man, no people are there. We go there, we set up the things are there. So this is the background of the civil engineering. So don't come get away with the thing that I will sit in my place and do the things. This is what I learned from the book biographies. And before getting into this, even considering the time, I will have some things to the students as a message to the students here. The first and the foremost is, please respect your teachers, your professors. Nowadays, I don't understand why this is happening across all the teachers. Even when I interact with my cousins who are doing their engineering and their degrees, I see students pull legs of teachers because they cut jokes on them. This is very, very bad quality because we have to respect the teachers. The guru is absolute. We were nowhere because if there is no guru, no teacher, there is nothing is there. So always respect your teachers. There is some, because even you see in the Sanskrit guru, the guru means darkness. The guru means the darkness, and ru is the path. The person who makes you, who enlighten you, who give the light, is the teacher. So respect your teachers. See, whatever you learn. From the perspective of the guru. Guru teaches you. The teacher taught you. Maybe a mother. She is also a teacher. So your father. So whatever you learn from some in the angle of a teacher. So respect the teachers. And the other thing is, you create a passion for civil engineering. So I'm not getting the movie name. I think it's Arjun Reddy movie. So everyone has seen the movie, Arjun Reddy movie. I hope everyone has seen. Definitely girls, everyone, boys, everyone has seen this movie. So everyone has taken many things from the movie. See the hero having a large bread. He smokes, he drinks. So people have taken everything bad out, only the bad things. But no one, because you see in the movie, he has the good fitness. If you see, I didn't get his name, the actor's name. So that person, the role of the hero, the person, he has a good fitness body. So no one is bothered about making the fitness of the body, but they will take other things. They will take other bad things from the movie. So when you take the things, take the good things as well. So do the exercise, be fit. That is what I want to say here. Other thing, what the civilian should adopt is you try to learn some other language other than the mother language, Telugu, and even Hindi. So most of the people cannot able to speak in Hindi because when I interact with the freshers. So other than Telugu, Hindi and English, you try to learn other languages, maybe some foreign languages like Arabic, French or German. So which because these are the languages which are spoken throughout the world. So you try to learn these languages, because this is mostly when you go to the in Middle East, so the Arabic is the most used, Arabic as well as the German is mostly widely spoken in the Middle East. So when you go to the Asian countries like Singapore, Malaysia, so Malay is a language which is widely spoken. So these are the spoken languages in the construction industry. So try to learn whenever you have a free time. Similarly, get yourself affiliated to the local chapters. That's great. I came to know that our college has been associated to Institution of Civil Engineers UK as well as India, Indian Institute of Engineers as well as IGBC. That's great. So please affiliate. I request all. My suggestion is every student should affiliate to some other organization. That's how you gain the knowledge. See how, because the civil engineering is like a technology is developing. How you know that the new technologies, new construction methodologies. Because unless you didn't get into some affiliated to any other institute, you don't get any proper information. Similarly, you can go through the websites. So keep on learning. So that is what people generally stop. After first year, second year, I have seen most of the engineers, most of the students, what happened after second year, they feel free. They feel that they achieved many things. They complete the plus two intermediate and they given the MCAT and they want to be relaxing mode. So keep away that thing, because you will be relaxed, but parallel you can do these things. I think Saturday and Sundays you have free time, then you can enjoy, you can go to hang out with your friends, go to beaches, have joyous life. But along with, because you want to be a, because you want to make a career in the civil engineering, so you have to be, do all these things. And the other thing is learn four-wheeler driving, because we work at sites and we sometimes on any emergencies we should drive vehicles. And so similarly, you learn the basic first aid. This is most of the hospitals they provide the basic first aid courses. So learn first aid courses, because it will be a lifesaver to you, and you can be a lifesaver too. You can make a life also. So it may be, sometimes it may be helpful when you are at home and you are some elder person needs some assistance, you can do the first aid. So similarly, also try to learn swimming, because most of we work at different sites in the river conditions. So this is one of the things which who want to be in a civil unit, these things can learn actually. Similarly, participate in all functions, colleges, programs. And many things, I think only few people will take the role, not like that. You make a turn this time. Suppose the person has taken a lead role in making an event. So next time, take the role on this. The other thing is what I see in engineers when they come from the fresh engineering from the colleges, they will have very generally they neglect the knowledge. They neglect on. Finance, one thing, and the accounts. Similarly, they have the negligence towards economics and management. So don't do any negligence on these parts, because these are also required for to be when you're growing up the career ladder. So one should understand the economics and the management. So one need not to be an expert in these fields, but may not be a master, but try to excel in this and try to understand the know-hows. Similarly, so even other thing is mechanical knowledge. You should have some little bit know-hows of the mechanical as well as electrical knowledge when you've been the civil engineer. Because we work in tandem with the mechanical engineers. Because there are machineries, there are excavators, you know, the excavators are there, the major, very huge machineries are there. So just have a basic knowledge of the mechanical engineers, there will be cranes and site. Similarly, you understand the electrical knowledge, electrical know-hows of the electrical knowledge, what is something like how the current passes on, how to do the body earthing of the machinery, like so on, so little things on these things. So if you also do some professional certifications in something like a Microsoft Office, you can do some certification, MSP, Microsoft projects. Similarly, you can take up IGBC. IGBC offers an accredited professional for students as well. So you can take up that examination. That examination very simple. So you should have a good knowledge on the environment. You can go to the website. So if you need help, I can, because I'm a LEED certified, I can help you, the people over here who want to do any certification programs. The most foremost thing is also, please inculcate the habit of studying three books other than the engineering. Don't read again, don't go back to and read again the engineering, hydraulics, mechanics. Keep away those things and study other books other than the, so pick up some books, pick up some, because I like autobiographies, so I read most on biographies. Otherwise, you like novels, you pick up novels and read. At least you keep a target that in this month, I'll read some three books, four books, or at least one book. You start reading. This will improve your English communication skills. It makes you think broader. So many books are there, so just read on those books. The other thing is, what I feel is, so as a civil engineer, so whenever, when you come to industry, create a love for the environment, think sustainability in everything you do. Whatever you do, think about the sustainability. I'm glad that our college is starting the event on the green buildings as well. Very, very much important. So sustainability is most important now. The final thing is the old students, the alumni are available to help you all at any time. Just pick up your phones and call. Even you can text. Sometimes maybe they may be engaged in other works and because of their daily schedules, routines. So text, WhatsApp and chat. Many people will definitely help you, the students. So they will support you, they will guide you, they will mentor you. We are there to support you. Dear students, we are with you. Please, 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 because you can take, I think someone can, we have, I think definitely college will have a database of the students with the numbers. You can call, you can just call him, otherwise you just put an email. Definitely, I feel that at least 60-70% people will respond if any of the students call or email. Definitely our alumni will support you. So, but mostly what happened, you should come, and because we don't know, if you have any doubts, you have to come to us. So that is a better way. You just pick up the, take the phone or email, because we have the database. So nowadays it varies because of the technology, you connect anytime. Because at that time we don't have any old student societies and such things are not available at our time. But now we have good number of batches have been passed. So people will definitely help you. Because I feel that most of our people have been successfully settled in their lives, and they have been if you see in my batch, all batchmates, we have been settled well because of the teachers here. They have been good professionals. They have done masters in US, and then all are mostly into the civil engineering field. So we are with you. Don't you afraid. Before I conclude, I appreciate the pain took by Teja, Ajay, I think Ajay and Aishwarya, who has called me and bringing us all us together here. I'm also happy that they are taking the legacy of the AAS Association of Civil Engineers. I very much joyful when Teja has told me that AAS is still continuing, because AAS was started by me. I was the first president of the AAS. I'm very much happy, get very much joyous, and still it is functioning and building the student relationship. I really enjoyed the celebrations. The theme here, the events are simply fabulous. I really enjoyed. Great job, organizers. Even today I got a chance because quickly today morning I got the invite. So I gone to the links provided in the email. So I got a chance to read the Nirman, the Times of Civil Engineering. That's very good source of information about civil engineering. They're very good articles because I'm not going into the detail. But in brief, so it's a good thing that there is a good connection is happening. So that what is the, because what happened, you learn something, the industry will be something. There should be some connectivity between the industry and the college that is happening to the Nirman. And if required something, I'll connect with my, in my network, all my friends, and they will, if Nirman editorial team say something, can we provided by the alumni, I ask my friends to share their case studies, their projects, because that is how you can improve on learning. So each alumni, if you share their project, so that is a great information. Great. So because I'm getting very sentimental, nostalgic, because when I'm talking, I'm getting all memories of the college are flashing back to me. Thank you, college management. And on the behalf of the batch of 1999, I pray for the health of everyone, and we all conquer this COVID-19, and this situation is not more going to be a longer time. And the good news is that you would have heard about the labor migration, people moving. The construction industry has been plagued because of this problem of the labor. But now the reverse movement has started. This festivals have been also timed. We are waiting for this October the Durga Ashtami, and the things are happening. The workers have been, reverse thing is happening. They're coming back to the construction site. The industry is reviving, and hopefully good things have been better. Maybe next another month or so, things will improve, because now when we opened up our sites, because of the lockdown, the sites have been shut down in the month of March. March 20th we shut down, because Bombay was the first place to shut down. We done the shutdown, and then we reopened on May 20th we started, because we thought we should start. So we started, because early, at that time we have only, I say, 5% of workers. Now as on date, so to my requirement, now we have around 70% of strength is there. So things, industry is revolving, don't worry. So we have good opportunities in the future. World will open up. So my dear students, good luck to all. Thank you the management, thank you the teachers here. That's all from my side. And this is over to Teja. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for sharing your experiences and for your valuable words.
Now, I would request Nikhila to introduce Sandeep, sir, our proud alumni and the guest of honor for the Engineers Day celebrations.
I consider it a privilege to introduce Mr. V. Sandeep Chaudhary. Mr. V. Sandeep Chaudhary has more than 6 years of experience in construction industry in various designations. He is an articulate communicator and been a key member of strategies and planning cell in the organization, with the responsibility of conducting review meetings with the key project members from the planning point of view. He is also a part of design, engineering, procurement, construction, operation, and maintenance of the Statue of Unity. His areas of interest are project controls, tendering, project management, site management, subcontracts administration, and contract management. Mr. Sandeep Chaudhary has been graduated in BTech Civil Engineering from our college in the year 2013. Now I cordially invite Sandeep Chaudhary garu to speak a few words.
So good evening all. So I would like to assure you that I'll complete this within 3 to 5 minutes. So I had just gone through Sir and Ms. Autobiography. So after going through, let me acknowledge you the fact that I neither have the experience nor age to speak about anything about him. But one incident I'll just say about him. At the age of 100, after he just crossed 100, a person came to him and he was going to Madras at the time. And I was like, sir, I'm going to Madras, so what do you want me to bring from there? So the person, sir, MB has replied stating that I just need an updated dictionary, latest dictionary. So this is one thing which I really felt amazing about him. At the age of 100, he's actually willing to learn. So that's it. That's one thing which we all should learn about. And coming on to the present status of the industry, which you all might be interested upon. To be frank, as of now, it's not so good. From the people working in different companies, I'm just getting information. Even from L&T, there might be a layoff around 1,000 employees. Even my own project manager has been will be laid off within 1 month. So situation in the country is not so good, as you all are aware of. And particularly in construction, it's not that great because many states are in going for overdraft, the RBI, and they don't have enough funds to pay the bills. So that's the problem. So the reason why I'm stating this is that the many of us, particularly the final year students who are aspiring for a job, it's going to affect you a lot. So that's the problem. So that's okay. As we are aware of it, that's fine. So what's the solution for it? So I was just thinking of what could we do from the college. So one suggestion which I would like to give, if at all you would like to take it, is that as of now, the student organization is really good, because at present, I think there were three chapters: Institute of Engineers, Institute of Civil Engineers, and IGBC, Indian Green Building Council. So there was a proper committee for that. I had seen the president, vice president, secretary, and Munchkanti sir is leading one of the chapters, and other sir is also leading chapters. So what could be done is that every year, like second year, third year, and fourth year, who are now listening, who are participating in this, you had a different requirements. Like fourth year students, it's high time for you. You will be coming out within 10 months or 12 months. 9 months from the line. So you have a different requirement. So all of you can form a group, and the president of the particular ICE can take the lead, and you can just make a strategy. So what I mean exactly is, so the advantage of thinking about it now is that after you come out of college, you're just a single person. But when you're in the college, you're a group of 100. So you can make a synergy out of it. So once you make a group, just see what are the different opportunities which you are willing. Like 30 students might like to do a job, and 20 students might be wanting to be an entrepreneur, or 15 students might be wanting to go for MBA. So once you form a separate groups, just try to get a mentor who is already in the industry, and make a route plan for that. So that would really help you out when you come out. So similarly, third year, you have a different requirement. Second year also have different requirement. So when you do this, actually, it will be really helpful, because the mentor will be helping you. The mentor can be like a professor from a college, or in fact, alumni who is working well in the industry. So that can be done. You all can just think of, if it is useful, you can just try to make it up. And one more point which Pavansa has told, which I like this, is that respecting our teachers, which is very, very important. I too heard from my previous teachers and school teacher also that the present students are not so willing, not so respecting the teachers. This is one thing which might seem as if I'm giving lectures, but The whole structure of student and teacher is that there's a beautiful relation between both of them. We should not pollute that. Once we pollute it, the structure collapses. So that's it. That's what we can take from the. So that's it. As time is not there, I would like to ask the organizer to go on to the next event. Thank you.
So Thank you, sir. Thank you for your delightful speech.
If the organizers permit, I would like to add on one point.
Sir, sure, sir.
Thank you. So, as Chaudhary said, because don't be bothered about the industry, because there have been many people have been fired because of the situation. But now the things are improved. Its industry is reviving. It's completely reviving. See now what happened just for on a. If you see on the figures of economics, there is an increase in the sales of two-wheelers, there is increase in sales of four-wheelers, because most of the people are now shifting from public transport to two-wheelers and four-wheelers in metros. So whether it is in Bangalore or in Mumbai, so people are changing, even in Delhi. So there is the sales have been increased. So before this lockdown, there were no sales of the low-end car models. But now the things have been changed. Now there is a selling like a hotcakes now. The things have been improving. Suppose if one industry is reviving, definitely other industries picks up. Because if some Mahindra needs to manufacture a car, they need some industry. They need to set up a workshop. So definitely they rely on engineers. So one industry picks up another industry. So definitely the things will improve. I mean it's definitely another two to three months things will change. A drastic change in the industry. Things will improve. There will be a lot of infrastructure projects coming up. So don't bother. But if you feel there are no opportunities, just go and take up some other things, like you prepare for the government exams, you do some professional courses. So don't worry about that. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Mr. Ajay, a student board member of IGBC student chapter, to launch the first leaflet.
Thank you so much for the introduction. Firstly, my warm greetings to one and all. We IGBC team are extremely honored to launch our first leaflet Prakriti in this grand occasion. Kaushik, please display our blog spot. So yes, so this is our blog spot. So with the permission of Principal Sir, HOD Sir, Dean Sir, and B.S. Rao Garu, and our guest of honor today, we would like to publish our leaflet, sir. So with your permission.
Proceed, please proceed, Ajay.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Publish. So, yes, Kaushik, publish. So, when we thought about the leaflet topic of a first leaflet, so we questioned ourselves whether green buildings ever existed before. So when we thought about it, we understood that all our ancient green buildings, most of it were green buildings only. Most of our ancient buildings are green buildings. So that we took our first topic to be on ancient green buildings. Kaushik, now please present the leaflet. So this is our leaflet. I really wish all of you will go through our blogspot, IGBC, GVPCOE blogspot, and read and give your valuable feedback. So we have included all the topics like courtyards, verandas, and chajjas, and basic other components of green buildings in our ancient green buildings. So, thank you so much, sir, for giving us the IGBC Executive Committee this opportunity. We are extremely grateful, sir. Thank you so much.
Good, Ajay. Thank you. Thank you.
Now I would request Ms. Nikla from third year to announce the prize winners for the events conducted on the eve of Engineers Day.
To mark the day, we have organized a few events. Now, I would like to present the PPT. Top three will get a merit certificate, and first prize winner will get the prize, which will be delivered to their house address. On the day of for the day of Engineers Day, we have conducted some events. First event is poster presentation. A poster is to be made by the participants with regard to the topics life of a civil engineer, and in architecture wing, modern house drawing, front elevation. In this event, digital art posters and art by hand posters were accepted. These are the posters of the participants. Winners of the event are S. Jahnavi Rajasri of third year from digital art category and P. Josna of second year from art by hand category. Moving on to the next event, name of the event is Invento. In this event, participants need to provide innovative ideas for solving the problem groundwater depletion in Visakhapatnam. Winner of the event is M. Manohar of fourth year. The next event is Build Your House. In this event, we have encouraged peer knowledge sharing among the students. In this aspect, we have organized a webinar on building planning and Vastu by one of our final year students, Mr. B. Saiteja, and also a workshop on 3D modeling using Revit software by one of our final year students, Mr. T. Uday Kumar. In this event, third place has been secured by T. Nagamadhavi of fourth year. Second place has been secured by KDK Akhil of fourth year. First place has been secured by C. Praveen Babu of fourth year. These are the models made by remaining participants. Moving on to the next event. It is Spotting Cipher. In this, participants need to solve some crosswords based on fun and knowledge. Winner of the event is Sushant from fourth year. Next event is Fiasco Quizite. This is an event which is based on failure of structures. In this event, participants need to give the appropriate reason for the failure of structures based on the video shown. Winners of the event are Yamuna of third year secured third place, and Sudhir of fourth year has secured second place. Tanuja of fourth year has secured first place. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikola. Now I would request one of the faculty members of the Department of Civil Engineering to express their views on the Engineers Day for a few minutes.
Sir, hello. Sir, okay. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good evening to you all, sirs, and my dear students and guests. Today, as you are all aware, that we are celebrating Engineers' Day, and on this occasion, it is my pleasure to say a few words. Every celebration we organize is due to some reason. Mostly celebrations will be organized on the festivals. I think today is our festival. Our engineer's god was Sir M.V. And those days, Sir M.V. doesn't have any facilities even to make calculations. Those days, they have at the best slide rule. Most of you are not aware. The slide rule was the only way our facet calculator, facet machine, to calculate the calculations. And now we have computers and calculators for calculations. With that time, the facilities were, even though the facilities were very, very less, they could able to achieve their targets, their desires to build the nation. The reason was the honesty in those people, and also sincerity. And Mr. Pawan Kumar has mentioned that punctuality of Sir M.V. I will just tell you one thing about his honesty. Mr. Pawan Kumar has also mentioned several examples. Those days, the power was not available at all places. So during night time, when he wants to work, he always keep two candles. One candle for his office work, one candle for his personal work. Those were the days the people were like that. Today we are reached to this level means because of those engineers, because of their dedication. So that's why I just mentioned that he is our god, engineer's god. So in this occasion, the college or our engineering department, the student associations have invited Pawan Kumar and Sandeep Chaudhary. They have delivered at length their experiences and advice to the students very nicely, and also extended their help to their juniors. I should thank them, both of them, in this regard. And one point I want to tell to the students that the present situation is a temporary one. We should not bother. We should face the situation. We should not get into fear. You will all get jobs. Only thing, certain things you have to fulfill yourself. One is skill. Really, you are all going to complete fourth year. You think yourself that, are you a complete engineer to take up the job? Suppose somebody is ready to provide you a job. Can you able to do? That is very important. So whatever, till you get the job, develop your knowledge. And as they have mentioned, Pavan Kumar and Sandeep Kumar, pursue your further education and prepare for competitive exams, etc. One point I want to tell you, I have observed in villages many times, in Telugu I will put, the people, the villages, in villages, because I have also come from village, వ్యవసాయం చేయమంటే తిట్టదు అంటారు. అంటే వ్యవసాయం లాభసాటి కాదు అంటారు. చేయకుండానే వాడు రోజు ఇంట్లో భోజనం చేస్తున్నాడు. చేస్తే డెఫినెట్గా లాభసాటే. బట్ ఏమిటంటే ప్రతి వాళ్ళకి సిటీకి వెళ్ళిపోవాలి, అక్కడ ఇల్లు తీసుకుని అక్కడ ఎంజాయ్ చేయాలనే దృక్పథం తప్ప, లేకపోతే అక్కడ కూడా లాభం వస్తుంది. చాలామందికి బాగా సంపాదించిన వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు. బట్ ఓన్లీ థింగ్, వాట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఈస్ ఎఫర్ట్. దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్ ద ప్రజెంట్ జనరేషన్. నాట్ ఆల్, ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. ద ఫెసిలిటీస్ ఆర్ అవైలబుల్ టు ఎవ్రీ వన్. ఎడ్యుకేషన్ గూగుల్ మీట్ ఆర్ సమ్ అదర్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్. Because I have seen the discipline that around 76 students are total strength is still there. It's very nice. Almost 2 hours function organizing well. I wish all the student chapters for organizing in a befitting manner on the Engineers Day. And we are all happy on this day because we are celebrating our God's Day. That is Sir MB. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspirational words. Now, I would like to invite a person who has been guiding the students in this department to conduct various events and this kind of celebrations. Our guiding light, Mr. Dr. Manchakanti Srinivasrao Garu, our faculty coordinator, Association of Civil Engineers, to speak a few words.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you, Teja. I hope my voice is reaching everybody. Teja, you may...
Yes, sir.
Respected P.S. Rao Garu, respected A.B. Koteswar Rao Garu, my dear senior colleague Professor Virbhadra Rao Garu, Krishnam Raj Garu, and my beloved HOD, Dr. Papa Rao, and two of my very good students, alumni of civil department. We are very proud of our two alumni students presently participating in today's Engineers Day, T. Pavan and V. Sandeep, and my dear colleagues in civil department, and my dear non-teaching staff colleagues, Hira Singh, Hanumant Rao Krishna, Shyam, Kiran, and my dear student friends. Good evening to all of you. If I missed anybody, it's unintentional. I'm really very happy to be a part of today's Engineers Day celebrations. Students have done exceedingly well, all the students of various chapters, and they have conducted very fantastic events. In spite of the COVID-19 pandemic, they have kept up their spirits, and they have organized a variety of events, and our two fantastic alumni, Pawan and Sandeep, have spoken very nicely, encouraging the students to take up the challenges ahead, which the students are going to face once they graduate from this college. It's been a very enriching experience, a very rewarding experience for me when I was interacting with the various students of various student chapter bodies. And I'm sure that the students have a lot of talent, lot of skill, lot of perseverance, lot of motivation, and they definitely will continue to do even better work in the future. And I wish that they continue to present even better ways via the student chapter bodies, as has been rightly pointed out by our two fantastic alumni, Sandeep and Pawan. And also, as already been pointed out by our HOD, that student chapters are very, very important for the department. Very nice. Thank you for making me a part of this fantastic event of today. Thank you so much, and over to Sai.
Thank you, sir. Now we are at the end of the celebrations. Now I request Manoj Prajumna, a third year student, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good evening to all present here. I, Manoj Pradyumna, would like to speak on behalf of Association of Civil Engineers, a student body of the Department of Civil Engineering, Gayatri Vidya Parishad College of Engineering, Autonomous. ACE is a parent body coordinating all the activities of different student chapters of the department. We thank our principal, sir, college management, and our HOD, Dr. G. Paparao, sir, for allowing us to organize Engineers Day celebrations 2020. We also thank Dr. G. Paparao, sir, and Civil Engineering Department faculty for emboldening us and helping us in taking crucial decisions for declaring the winners of the events conducted by us. We once again thank our Civil Engineering faculty for acting as judges for various events conducted by various student chapters during the Corona time, and for the various events organized in connection with the Engineers Day celebrations. I would thank our alumni T. Pawan sir and Sandeep sir for accepting the invitation to come to our event. We are grateful to our respected Dr. Manchikanti Srinivas sir for always being in our support, and for his positivity and encouragement brightened our works. You made us a better and more thoughtful students. We are thankful to our seniors with whom we have worked for this event. And thank you so much, seniors. We have learned a lot from you. We would like to wish you all with a bright career and a peaceful life. We are thankful to our classmates and juniors who are taking active participation in our events and helping us without any hesitation. We thank all our civil department students who have come to attend this event. Thanking you all once again for your time, resources, and even knowledge. Thank you.
So thank you, everybody, for your patient listening and active participation. And I thank Sandeep and Pawan for your valuable information you have shared to the your junior brothers and sisters. Thank you very much for joining with us. I thank you one and all on behalf of the department and my personal behalf. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Pawan, and thank you, Sandeep. Very nice.
Thank you.
Nice that you spent time with us and shared your experiences with the budding civilians of our department. Thank you. You've spent very good time, and you've given valuable advice to our students. And definitely the students will look forward and look upon to you, to Pawan and Sandeep, to, you know, take their careers forward. Students, you try and keep in contact with our former alumni, our former students, the alumni, Mr. Pawan and Mr. Sandeep, and try and get inspired by the recipes. Also, nice. Thank you so much for coming over, Pawan and Sandeep, participating today's university function. Thank you. Very nice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I know Sandeep, but I do not know Pawan because they have joined in the year 2012. I think
first batch were very, very small, less in number actually, around 28 to 29, I guess. 30 kaad kada? 28. Okay, 30 anukunna first intake. 29 chala, 29, 28 chala small chakaga. Those were the days.
Don't mention thank you. This is due to the college, back to the college. Mention not.
Oh, nice.
Your messages will be helpful to our students, definitely.
Definitely, sir. Definitely.
Very nice.
Sandeep, I would like to share one incident.
Sandeep, 1 minute. We asked the students to leave. Sandeep.
Sure, sir.
Teja?
Yes, sir.
Please ask all the students to leave.